Hey everybody, it's Tony here with Safeguard. I wanted to take a second and talk about a mistake that I'm seeing almost 100% of the time. So far this year, we've probably ran about 75 reviews for you know, different people. And what I found is out of those 75 people, about 50 of them have a brokerage account, whether it's a joint brokerage account or an individual brokerage account. They have some kind of account outside of IRAs, 401ks, stuff like that. Just their own, you know, investment account. And what I found out of those 50 people is like 49 of them had this type of account. So this would be for like a married couple, joint tenants with rights of survivorship. And I'm here to tell you that this is the wrong joint account type. And I don't mean that there's some other like gimmicky way. I'm actually going to show you how you can potentially save a couple $100,000 in taxes with a really simple change. So first I want to walk you through an example, because I find that it just helps people understand it a little bit better. For a minute, we're just going to pretend that you have a $1 million brokerage account. So you did awesome outside of your 401k and your IRA and your Roths and all that stuff. You also had an extra million laying around. You got it in a regular just brokerage account. And this account is going to be a joint account. So let's say you walk into my office and I see right here it says something like tenants in common or joint tenants or joints with rights of survivorship. The way the government looks at that, if you're married, is that $500,000 of that account is yours and $500,000 of that account is your spouse's. So it's literally 50-50. And we're just going to say real quickly that to make this a little easy on the math side, we're going to say your original cost. So you originally paid $200,000 for these positions and you have big giant gains. So you have $800,000 of gains over here. And the way, again, that the government's gonna look at this is this tenant has a $100,000 cost basis. This tenant has a $100,000 cost basis. This one has $400,000 of gains and this one has $400,000 of gains. So that's kind of how they look at it. So what happens is if one of you were to pass away, so we're gonna just say, this spouse over here, you know, terrible accident or something, and they pass away. The way it currently works is this surviving spouse gets a step up in basis. So right here, that $400,000 of taxable gains goes away and becomes cost basis. So now this surviving spouse, they have $400,000, $500,000, $600,000 of cost basis and only $400,000 of taxable gains. So I mean, that right there saves them, we'll just, you know, say a rough number because I don't want to get into the details on the math, but they save somewhere $50,000, $100,000, $150,000 in capital gains taxes. But we live in a special state. So in Wisconsin, we live in a marital property or community property state. And this is really special because what that means is if you have the right type of account, the correct type of joint account, which again is not joint tenants with rights of survivorship. It's a totally different account type. But you can actually have it where if either spouse passes away, the surviving spouse gets the full $1 million tax-free. They get what's called a double step up in basis, where this entire amount that's taxable gains, they get totally for free. No taxes, no capital gains, you know, no income, none of that. So they would actually inherit. You know, if me and my wife, this is the easiest way to describe it. Me and my wife, we have a joint account. And it's structured for a marital property state. So if something were just gonna happen to me, she would get that entire account tax-free. Okay, and I'm seeing so many people that have these joint with rights of survivorship or joint tenants or these other things, where they're literally leaving half of any of the capital gains on the table, meaning they're leaving the surviving spouse a higher tax liability than they needed to leave them. And there's really no good reason for it. I mean, the thing I'll say is most advisors out there that we talk to, they don't even know about this. You can learn a little bit more about this concept by just Googling like double step up in basis. But here's where the rubber meets the road. If you say, hey, I wanna learn more about this. I wanna learn if I have the right type of joint account. Just comment down below, say, hey, I'd like to chat. You know, I'd like you guys to review my joint account and see if I have the proper titling, the correct titling. And from there, we've had relationships with a lot of different companies. I've heard from TD Ameritrade, Charles Schwab, Trust Company of America, a lot of different trust companies, a lot of places that hold money right now. And what I can tell you is every single one of them, the correct title of the account is different. Okay. And I don't want to go through them all. I don't want to go through all the forms and turn this into an hour-long video. So what I'll say, just to save everybody time, if you want to review on that titling in your joint account, just comment down below and say, hey, I'd like to chat. Or if you don't want to comment, you know, go ahead and just shoot me a private message and just say, hey, Tony, I'd like to chat. I would like to, have you guys look at my account and see if we have it structured properly to save me on the capital gain side. And I'll tell you, no matter who your custodian is, we'll be able to track down and help you figure out what the right form is and what the right title for that account is to make sure that you're paying as little taxes as possible and putting as much money as possible in your own pocket, because that's what we're here for. And I just want to remind you, you don't need more money. You need a better plan, a plan that gets you double free taxable tax savings. So take care, guys.